Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Xcite Racing League's GP3 division. It is round three of the championship coming to you around the Bahrain International Circuit under the floodlights here for the final round of races on around Bahrain this week. My name is BHA Captain Wason. I'm joined in the box by two people here tonight, F1 at Speed, as per usual, streaming here. He had a break on last night, so he's back and he's raring to go for this one. But also we have a brand new commentator slash steward who will be taking over from myself from next week onwards. It is Sundance Kid, so good evening to the pair of you. And just so people are aware of who you are, Sundance, give a little introduction of yourself.
I'm Sundance Kid. I race XRL for just come up, probably get halfway to Britain, it'll be one season. Very glad and proud to run. I've been on Xbox Live for 4 years. Good boy and everybody. Hey, we all have a bad streak then again. I just want to see good, clean racing and Mick, it's a great track, and as you know, the surf is here, Mick. It's also the same mixture of surf. Abby Dabby.
See, now you already told me this an hour ago. I did not know that.
You know, I've been up crashing it all day on Google, getting all the little facts up and all the little things, and yeah, it's been great. It's been everything. But anyway, mate, let's get back to the commentary on the qualifying. Let's see people have started so far.
Indeed. So Gary Allburn has actually set the fastest lap at the moment, a 132.0, which is a pretty good lap time indeed, for especially for this division. He's one of those who people have seen during practice, including myself. He's very, very quick around here. The only problem that he's got is consistency during a long race. And it's a long race, of course. 100% race distance around here. Jism is currently second on a 32.6. Although I do think the times are going to get a lot faster. So let's get on to somebody. Gary is currently on a in lap. Just note also, we have only 10 drivers here at the moment, which is weird to see because we're missing the likes of Anguished Ear, a couple of others as well, but most notably XRL Button, the joint championship leader after two rounds, joint of course with Adam Lee. To go through the rest of the table, actually, we've got some time. Sundance, I believe you have it, so
yep.
Do you want to go through it for us?
Leading the table at the moment in first place is Adam Lee and XRL Button, both on 40 points. Closely followed by Gary Allburn with 24. I mean, one race, good position. Yep, you can get one. Fourth place is Jism on 20. Fifth, we have Blake Emery, in fact we have 25th, Mick, Blake Emery and Rank Bubbles, both on 12 points. 6th place is... got 3 people on 6, Mick, MM Shops, Strike of Fire and Anguish here. And then we finally go down to the last guy in top 10 is Clark. 4 points, but as I say, it's early in the season, mate. Plenty to play for.
Definitely plenty to play for, but only 10 rounds left in the season. Make you win this challenge. SP3. To them, a wise call to make or not?
I think it's a strategy call, mate. I can see where he's going. I mean, a lot of people would say it's a strange one to go with, but definitely see where he's going with this one, mate.
Troops gone second.
What do you think, though? Is there any reason why he should be setting a lap on primes here?
No, because even if you start the front on options, you can... Yeah, as in, you qualify on options, you can start on prime, so not really. Maybe he wants to save his options for the race. Maybe he's planning on doing a few more stops than most of them being for options.
Ricardo's leapt up to P4.
I think he's going to go for a long prime stint, get all the guys on the options out of the way, that way he gets his top. And then I think when they've got their primes on and he's got his options, his first stint, I think he's just going to go, mate. I think he's going to build up a big lead. Well, last night he hit a 31 on options. So I'm thinking he's sitting there thinking, I've got the pace, but I don't need to use the options. And on the lighter car, with those fast tyres, as you know, you're going to be going twice as quick. So I can see where he's going there. Double thumbs up there for Adam, mate.
Maybe he's thinking, you know, set a banker lap on the prime tyres. Maybe he knows exactly the pace that he can get on the options. He's just waiting around. Blake Emery is now starting a lap on, he's currently P6 on a 33.1, coming down into the first sector now. This is the apex, though, by quite some margin, but it's not really something you need to do around here into turn one. Takes through turn two and three very well. Coming up into turn four, it's going to be an overtaking.
Ricardo's graveled it at the end of the first DRS straight.
Oh dear.
He's hit the wall as well, he's lost an end plate.
Don't want to be doing that around here. It's going to be one of those, because it's a long race, 57 laps around here for tonight. Because it's a long race, you do not want to be making mistakes. Consistency is the key to winning. I mean, realistically, you can win from any place on the grid. I know that sounds silly, but trust me, you can do that. Kimi Räikkönen, if you remember back in 2006, actually got third from starting at the back. I mean, I know that was the first track round here and everything else, but
different layout,
Yeah, it just shows though.
Never give up
around here. As Blake Emery's now coming to the end of the middle set, has a reasonable lap so far, but I have to ease off. Oh, he's gone wide there through the penultimate corner. Now down into the final corner, which is very easily go on the inside and accidentally cut your lap. But he hasn't done that, and he's come through.
He's
now
avoided
he's
all the curbs.
Go across, and he improves by a slight bit. But
that was 700ths or something like that.
Pole. 5 minutes to go.
Gary said be back in 10 at 9 minutes to go, by the way. So he's not going to say another lap, I don't think. Don't know where he's gone, but he's had to go somewhere. So, yeah.
He's not setting a lap, but he's currently on pole position. And that would be good for me because I've got him down for the Predictor League for pole position. Some people said I was crazy, but there we go.
You still could be. Four and a bit minutes to go.
Yeah, just a note in the Predictor League, it's going very well so far. We've got, I think, at least 10 people now involved. But Andy Ferrandi picked out the most points last time out, last night. He got 8 points altogether, getting first, second, third, and fourth correct. He's currently the record point scorer in the Predictor League at the moment, so that's very good for him.
I've heard my window's gone a bit cold, so it's not the best plan in the world, is it?
Right, so let's see if he can grab opposition. Gary's coming out again.
Also, he's back now.
Yeah, he is back now. Somebody in the pits is going very slow. He's letting Tube Animal through. We're worried about space there. Still no sign of X-Rob.
Oh, Jism got fought off by the curb. He was on a nice lap. Not going to improve now. That's going to bummer him. He's gone put down a fourth. Someone's beat him in second. He's gone somebody else. It's Blake. He's gone second.
I do have somebody that can come in. But it was one of the drivers that mentioned. I don't know whether Button tested him or not. I will rehab.
No, he didn't test it, so we can't. Adam Lee's on options as well, by the way, now.
Blake has gone into second.
I said that, right.
Yeah, there's a 10th covering the top three, 3 minutes to go.
Adam is on the options again, don't know if whether he's definitely improving his time, but don't know where it's going to put him. He did mess up the hairpin, you saw it. Chisholm was going to improve on his lap before he messed up the last corner and he got flung off by the curb, so room for improvement on all of their laps really at the moment, I think.
I'm not sure whether Tube Animal cut his lap. Oh, he's gone very, very, wow, that is an interesting line into the final corner bomb from Tube. Went right off the track and went back on again. Is he going to improve on his time? No, he doesn't. No, so he might have corner cut his lap. Blake is slow. Barry's is starting one. Where is Adam? He's going to be...
Ninth. Oh, someone's just beat... He's I think Adam's Barry. Just crossed the line.
Adam's
there you go.
31-8. So Gary knows this now. It's only two temps. All you need to find is two temps, Gary.
Jism keeps messing up the last corner and he's hating it. You can see him improve the whole lap until the last corner where he just runs wide each time.
I had that last night in quali. Could have easily improved mine by two either. Temps, but I kept on messing it up.
Ferrari's in ninth and tenth.
Gary doing his usual thing, which is rowing the engine as it goes around every single corner, but seems to be working for him so far. Oh, he had to turn out of the annoyingly tricky double left-hander there, going onto the back straight. He turned in and realised he was turning in too early. He had to back out of it. Come on, Gary. You have confidence now. I know you're quick. You can do this. Oh, it's gone over the curbs, though.
Tube could go pole. He's not gonna though, I don't think.
Nope.
Oh, no. No, he must have cut then.
They're on their last lap now. And Adam Lee doesn't improve on his time.
Come on, Jism. Jism didn't go wide this time on the final corner. Has he got enough grip and fuel left? That's my question. Does he improve on his time at the moment? Yes, he does. Puts him fourth. There you go.
31.
That lap was done with a bad run out of the last corner as well from the last lap, so I wonder if he'll improve on his lap now if he has enough fuel and grip left.
He sneaked ahead from Tube Animal by 5 thousandths of a second. Fantastic. Like, Gary's messed up. Gary's messed up in the middle sector. He's gone wide. That's hit his hump for ball position down, but does Chisholm have enough time to do another lap? Does Tube Animal have enough time?
Charlie Pop improves. Adam Lee is on one.
Tube got his last one.
Yep. Oh, I went to go to second, but it didn't allow me to. I don't know why. And it's not allowing me to still, so Gary must have cut somewhere.
Yeah. Stop's gone. So Gary, well, front row at the very least, I suppose. Or Adam, I don't know. Yeah.
At the very most, really. Because they still could beat him.
That's what I meant.
Just. Now, is he going to improve this time?
I don't know, this looks pretty good. But he,
nope.
No, he doesn't. No, he does not
improve. But his teammate doesn't.
Adam hasn't either. Jism is the most amount. He does have enough fuel, doesn't have enough grip. Looks okay. Oh no, he cut the final corner. Oh, he's going to be gutted with that, but fourth place still was pretty good. There's only the two Ferraris left, Shots.
Yeah, and one of them had a lag spike, so it's only really Shots, and Shots didn't even use his DRS down them home straight.
Only on the 33s at the moment. Jollypop is 7/10 of his teammate, not very good at all. Found the final corner to Shots, no. That's it done. Jollypop, I don't think he's going to improve, but he's going for it. 32, 33, finishes a tenth behind his teammate, but there you have it, pole position for Mr. Adam Lee, but look at that top four, even that top five, covered by 4/10. Wow. Ridiculous timing. Adam and Gary on the front row, Blake and Jism on the second row. So, Adam on pole. Only two people in my predictor league said Adam for the pole, and that is Beastass and XRL Hamilton. So two valuable points between them. One valuable point each, I suppose I should have said.
Yeah, you probably should have. No button then.
No way it went. Indeed.
He even advertised it earlier on Twitter that he was ready for this race. I retweeted it and everything, but sadly, something must have got him. Good lap by Adam is what Hector Hamilton says. I predict a riot at turn one, says Azar Reactions. He predicts a riot at turn one.
You predict every single thing, can't you? Will you predict that there's a possibility of a safety car here in this race? Haven't had one yet, which is weird. I thought there would be. Those bollards,
there's going to be one now. Thank you.
Yeah, there is going to be one. It'll be free.
Yeah.
Indeed. So.
Why do you say go? Free? Just to be more annoying. Did that actually happen now?
So, to go through the grid order, they go for Sundance.
Yep. First place in pole was Adam Lee with 31.8. Second, Gary Albone. Third, Blake Emery. Fourth was Chisholm. Fifth, Tube Animal. Six, Ricardo. Seven, Rex Bubbles. Eight, XRL Tracer Fire. Nine, MM Shock of the Ferrari. And 10, Johnny Pop of the Ferrari. I would say a risky arena that he would be assuming at the moment.
Indeed.
Indeed
it would be. Interesting thing to note as well, that the people on the front row are the only people that have got their year of birth in their game attack. Inspired.
And they're both older than me.
Yeah, Mike.
Well.
Cheese.
There we go.
Yeah, they're both older than me is what I said.
So, in terms of predictions, I'm just going to say who's going to win. I have myself who thought Adam's going to win. Wes, that hasn't helped out for you, has it? Because you said Button's going to win.
Oh crap, can I change that because he didn't even turn up?
No, can't change it.
I say Blake now.
Can't change it. Well, you can change
it. Yeah, I say Blake. You know. So if Blake wins, then I'm taking that.
Taking for Gary, here we go.
Taking Gary, alright.
Andy Ferrandi also went with Adam, so did Beastar, so did Hamilton. Best went with two Venomals, so that is still, I mean, anybody of the top five, really six, could win this race. Anybody could win. Really, to be honest,
but
let's see what the thoughts of the drivers are going to be. We're going to game chat now. Hope they're not talking about what.
Yeah, we're swearing. Yeah, we're swearing.
Probably.
Let it go. Is Michael not like the cheeky dude?
It's like giving away children, isn't it? He's giving away us to.
That's a bit easier.
What?
That's not gonna left.
Are you ready for your race?
Oh yeah, more than ready.
Draco back.
Okay. Well, before we go, don't ready up yet. Sundance, ask them a few questions. Yeah. Let Sundance get into this.
Chisholm, do you think you could have improved on your time, though? You were looking really good.
Not really. I've improved in my personal best, so that was good enough for me.
Tube Animal, you looked like you was on a flyer, mate. You really did, though. Just when you come to the second last, looked like a little bit over the curve on the right-hand side. Do you feel yourself that you could have, you didn't do that, you could have got the pole, though? I personally thought you was going to get it.
I thought I'd get it at least, well, second. I don't think I would have got the pole.
I thought you would have got to get it, anyway, I must admit. Jots and Johnny Pop. Dudes, I said in the stream, when you probably watch it afterwards, Maurizio Riva Benny was probably fuming. Do you guys think you had a bad quality and that you definitely do better on the right side? I certainly think you will.
Definitely.
I think. Yeah.
Yeah,
I think you will, dude, definitely. Just don't forget, guys, that anything can happen, dudes, and anyone can win this race. Anything, if any safety cars come out, just make sure you're aware of what you're doing, guys. And, yeah, man. Have a good one, guys. Have a really good one,
predictions?
Okay, I'll go. Okay, I'll go with a few.
Yeah, I'll be last.
I'll go with the top three that each of my predicted leagues have gone with. So I went with Adam for the win, Gary for second, Jizz and third.
Thank you.
Wes went with Button to win. That's not gonna happen.
Yep, I've changed that to Blake.
Two Animals second and Adam third. Andy for Andy went with Adam for the win, Button second, Two Animals third. Beastass went with Adam for the win, Button second, Jollipop third. X-War Hamilton went with Adam for the win, Button second, Gary third. And Ice the Best went with Tube Animal to win, Adam second, and Bubbles third.
Can I just say something really shocking at the moment?
Why do you always say that? Oh my god.
He always asks, can he say something? Yes, Gary.
Win, Adam for second, and either Blake or Tube Animal for the podiums.
Soda Figo win 3-0 against Barcelona.
We don't care, my god!
Please, no one said he asked for the Reebok because I'm recording it.
Oh, let's go, let's get this over and done.
Gary, for that, I hope you hit the bollard.
Keep it nice and smooth, don't do anything right, and you'll
just for that.
Right, just enjoy it, just enjoy it.
We'll be going to track shortly, be aware.
Do this. What
the hell was that?
I don't know.
Everybody on stream said Michael make an arr noise.
I'm too excited.
Why is that your excited noise? Mine's like a screech. Like,
I'm excited about tomorrow because FIFA 16 is out for me.
Okay. I'm not because I got college and work. I'm not excited about anything.
I don't because I'm not working.
You say, haha, but I will build a race car out of my money.
Pole position. Gary Allbone is on the front row. Unbelievable
not surprised.
Stuff.
No, why is it keeping me in a cockpit?
No XRL button here. We've got 57 laps around the Bahrain International Circuit. And we're going to go for 3, 4, 5 lights out and away we go. Going down into turn one. Who's going to get a good start? Adam Lee's got a reasonable start. Gary's on the inside, but he's not. Is he going to do a dive bomb into here? No, he is not. There's 3 or 4 wide in the pack. The two Ferraris are trying to make up positions. There's a Lotus sideways, or Lotus has spun. I don't know who that was.
There's Bubbles. That was just full. Oh, and Jism. Jism went in the gravel.
Oh no.
Now Jizzen got in the gravel.
Jizzen seems to be fine.
Good, don't even know how you end up in the... That side pod just seemed like full wide didn't go. It's understandable.
Yeah, Shops is on Primes, he's up into P5 on the first corner. Draco fires into 6, goes wide as a hairpin. Wow, Shops have had a fantastic start, but all things considered, that's several drivers in the wars. Jizzen, Ricardo, and RNK Bubbles is struggling to get back up into pace.
Yeah, no damage on the cars.
Draco fighting with Jollipop to keep his 6th place and just does so down the second long straight. Oh, there's a tail snap at him and then Jolly's through. Oh wait, no, he's not really. Just about. What about the next corner? Just gonna keep that. Draco didn't give up either, and I don't think he will down the next straight either. No DRS yet. He's gonna have to slipstream. Does it? Looking into the last corner. No. What about it? Oh god, Jolly gone. And Draco will go through. Looks like Jolly going wide.
Oh, if Benham was trying to have a look at Blake into third, it's the front four steaming away.
He's not got the first traction. Hello, Blake's come
Blake
back at him.
Still there. Blake is still there. He's fighting it.
Blake's quit. Blake's kept there.
Nice.
Good driving there, but Blake.
Adam Lee's not broken away from Gary at the moment. Gary's sticking him for like glue.
Sticking him like two light blue. Light blue. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Don't know where the two came in, is that? But yes. Correcting you on grammar, that's not the thing I would do, but I'm sorry about that.
Looks like the Ferrari of shots on his prime tyres, holding up a real train in the midfield there. One person out of that first lap, I really feel sorry for, is Jism, because you heard in his comments before we start the race, personal best was beaten. Definitely high up on the grid, and he's down there. I think he's down in 8th at the moment at the back of that train. Yeah, he's got slipstream on the back of Adam. He might be going
same
for the lead here
into turn 1.
Same
with Tube. Tube's going for 3rd.
Oh no! Side pod! Adam spun round off of Gary.
Don't think that was Gary's fault, so I don't blame him if he continues. Does that look...
not waiting up.
No, I wouldn't either. That looked the lightest side pod in the world.
It looks like Adam really turned into Gary there.
Yeah, he just looked like he tapped him. That was the smallest tap in the world for a big spin. I don't blame Gary for not weighing up, because I did this 2 seasons ago when someone tapped me, I just get going. That was his fault,
down anyway.
Yeah, still had to write it down, but I don't think that was his fault.
Don't
sadly,
so,
just,
but it's,
no.
But it's dropped Adam back.
Draco's
right
4th.
Go on, Draco.
Draco passed shots and Jollypop as well. He's blocked them both. Adam, he's probably a bit raged. And got DRS, he got really passed.
If he's corner cut though, that's an illegal overtake.
Yeah, but he's got a lap to give it back.
He's not giving that back.
He might be re-overtaken down the straight with DRS.
Oh, the two Ferraris side by side behind, my god.
Jollypop can get him, I think, out of the exit.
A little bit of coming together. Shots and Jolly are really, really close to one another. Draco's looking at the back of Adam. For Adam's sake, Draco's got to get by, if that's a legal overtake done. We were up at the front, two banner was gone into second. Past Adam Lee.
Well, Adam Lee's in 4th, so there you go, Adam's not got past.
Right, so that's lap 3, turn, what turn is that?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, around about 10 straight 11. 10/11, so because did it, passed him on the straight, but cut the corner before the straight to help the run.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. So, Adam, while he was leading this race, has now been a little bit ruffled. It's the 3 leaders, Gary, Tube, and Blake. Top 3.
It won't be long until he's back on him.
Would want to be coming straight back at these
3
leaders.
He will. He'll catch him quickly, I think, because he's not actually that far behind.
Jollypop has got past his teammate Shots. Shots still on those prime tyres, of course.
Holding up Jism and who's that? Jism and Ricardo.
Oh, Ricardo's hit the back of Jism though. That was just got caught out by his braking, I suppose. The tour base, they're going to the final corner now. Ricardo's going to have DRS on the back of Jism. Is Jism going to have DRS? He is. Cancelled out, really, with this train. Ricardo's nowhere near close, and I don't think anybody is for an overtake. Oh no!
What?
Everybody, Constantina's up. They'll just hit each other like dominoes.
I had some lag. 10 second penalties for MM Shots and Ricardo, by the way, in game.
Wow. I don't know what they've got those for. Probably for turn 1. Yeah, probably for turn 1 is what I'm thinking.
I'm just going to stand on this screen until my lag stops, so give me a minute. Right now. This lag.
Seems to be a trait with this track in the early stages. Nobody seems to be able to... Is that something that both of you have noticed over race watching it?
I don't know about you, but my own personal experience is racing on it, if you... As soon as your tyres start to go and you don't do it to control your tyre, it's very hard to keep yourself going or you lose rhythm. Very hard, I mean, physically. Then you lose your rhythm. That itself. I mean, I personally, when I was... I tell you, one like the guys last night. What about you, Wes?
What exactly was the question?
Well, the question was about the track, though. Keeping the rhythm up and
consistency.
It's... Yeah, once you got a rhythm around it, it's fantastic. Yeah, there's a few corners you can make mistakes. There's a few places the curbs can throw you off. That's annoying. But... It's one of those tracks, I put it in the same aspects as really China and Hungary, of it's okay, I can work with it. It's not too difficult, not too easy. Especially with the left-hander. Quite low, left-hander.
Lots of overtaking, lots of overtaking opportunities.
The one thing I don't like about this track is the curbs. The curbs are very, very vicious. It's not being a favourite playground of mine, if that's really the term to say about it. I mean, it's obviously very easy to turn in too early, hit those bollards and destroy your car on impact. Tube Animal has DRS in the back of Gary, not going into his slipstream, oddly enough. Looking for the outside line going into here. He can carry it all the way around and get past, but Gary defends very, very well, but does get very good traction coming out of that turn. And Tube Animal's right up his gearbox now as they come up into there. Bubbles is disconnected. I'm not sure whether that is...
I don't know where he was.
He was right at the back. He was about 10 seconds off. Not sure about that, but we'll be down to 9 runners and riders. Disappointing for Bubbles. He'll be out of this race only lap 7. Oh, and wow.
Yeah, first gear definitely.
Bollard.
Just a random question to Thundas. I'm out as I have lag where the mask is, since I stop. I hope I stop now. How close can you get to the mic? Can you get any
yep.
closer?
Yep.
There you go, I'll be fine with that. There you go,
yep.
That'd be good.
Okay, no worries,
please. You need to bear with Wes, because the...
Yeah, sorry about that.
Because you're new, you need to sort of configure.
I need to work stuff out.
So you can hear it.
Mm.
But what it was is I had the mic away from my mouth because I've got a deep voice and I don't want to sound like Darth Vader on the mic.
Fine at the moment. It sounds a lot more clear. Well, Gary,
yeah.
Right over the curbs in the final corner. Oh, he's weaving a lip. Defending. I don't know what he's doing, actually.
He's going to the middle. No, wait.
And to the right.
That's more than
one move.
I think I know what he was doing. I know what he was doing.
What?
I know exactly. He was weaving for the corner cut. But tubes through anyway. He was weaving for the corner cut.
On the main street, Ricardo come up to shots. Oh.
That moment when my internet turns terrible. There you go, was waiting for that. Bloody hell. I called that in my head because of the amount of lag there's been. Sorry about this. Once I lag out once, I won't lag out again, but it's just a pain in the ass. Right, once I lag out once, I won't lag out again. I just saw that one coming from a mile off.
What happened at Sundowns? You said, ooh, quite a few times.
Yeah. Right, on the, what I was seeing, Ricardo was on the inside going around to the double left where you get DRS on the back straight. On his right hand side was shots, and then Johnny Pop went on the outside, but whatever happened, Johnny Pop ended up off the track and Ricardo came in front. I don't know if it was a case of, I don't know, but the other cars seem to be fine. Checking on them now, make sure there's no damage on either of them.
Something happened to Big Animal in the meantime. Adam Lee has actually come up right to these leaders and he's DRSing past Blake Emery. Can he get the car up in time? Yes, he can. Into P2. He is recovering very, very nicely indeed. Up with the leaders now. Gary's got a couple of seconds. And Tube Animal was with Gary, was with battling, and I was checking. He's gone.
Chris, my reply to you, Chris, is I need to reset my router, but my parents won't allow me to, so that's why I lag out quite a lot, I suppose. I just need to give it a reset, but they just won't allow me to, because of cameras.
Ooh,
that was a weird line by Adam.
Yeah, I don't know where he's going.
The good thing he's actually stayed on the track, but maybe some, I don't even know what that was.
Well,
I wouldn't even count that as overseer.
When we was doing the race, he did say there was a decent ice cream parlour out there somewhere, so I don't even
know
if it was an ice cream, but yeah, man. He did say
reward himself with an ice cream.
Tube Animal coming up behind Blake.
Adam in front got caught on the curbs. Just the tab.
Don't like
very,
those curbs.
Very lucky he didn't spin him off into the wall. I think he had like a quarter of a spin.
I must admit, I'm feeling pretty confident about my prediction of Gary winning. I think I might have given the urge to actually get a win.
Oh, you're speaking way too soon for Gary.
Speaking way too soon.
There's a number of laps that Gary could drop it somewhere in the wall.
What's
thanks for plugging my Twitter momentarily. You're welcome, Joe. I didn't even notice I did, but I'll plug it again later.
I always cheer for the underdog, guys. I mean, Adam's definitely the favourite. I was going to say Adam, but I'm myself.
Yeah.
I'll go with the underdog. But yeah,
Gary's definitely the underdog, yeah, I agree with that.
The underdog has still yet to win an Xcite Racing League, even though he's been in an occasion to win a race so many times. I mean, it's like
about five, six, yeah. Yeah, about that.
Even his very first race he could have won in Monza.
Yep.
Which he got a podium.
Start right at the back. Course Goose, ask your mum to follow in Michael's footsteps, #11pm at night night. No, I'm not taking
it. He could have had a dive on the inside, but Blake completely missed the apex by a mile. Two animals side by side. Blake's got to go have the inside for this corner here. It's going to be tricky to get them both through, but two animals backs out of it.
Smart racing there. He went for the DRS, I think.
They've both got it.
Oh,
it's a race to the
end.
It's a drag. Another tricky corner. It's going to be a long left hand.
Just.
The right line, but Blake's still there. Blake
to the inside.
Inside, no.
She's got the momentum.
The outside, fantastic stuff.
Not
still
done yet.
Blake's back inside again.
Oh God. She's gonna get DRS here. Don't you dare break. Don't any one of you break because this is side by side.
Are they gonna have to break now?
I was gonna say don't break the DRS. Blake's
on
the
inside line.
Think about him on the inside. He's making a pit. I think he is.
He is. He's the first one in the
pit. DRS for Tube, but he's not opened it. I don't know why.
I think he wanted to.
No, not.
Very wide in turn one.
Oh yeah, I don't know what's wrong with it, Chris. To be honest with you, it does that. It just does that from time to time. It goes, actually, I'm gonna lag quickly for you and reset. So it sort of resets itself. I don't know why. I never used to.
Where is Blake going to come out? What tyres is he on?
He's on
prime tyres, come out in clean air, which is good for him.
Arrow hit the bottom on that 21, so it's Maddie, probably. God. Bubbles.
Gary so far on the fastest lap, with 35 dead.
Confidence.
Is that really?
0-1-8. Yeah, 35. Oh, no,
really?
I was a little bit too drunk there. I thought he had the fastest lap. I do apologise to everybody. I thought he had the fastest lap, but no, he definitely does not. Adam does with a 34.593.
Problem with Adam Lee though is he's had to recover from this, so
Yeah.
But
well, he's got in place in a good. He's got himself in good, you know, back to where he needs to be. Just he would be ahead, but he's still there in the shot, you know, especially with the amount of laps to go. Well, Speed Demon said the confidence in Gary is real, as Adam Pitts, I think.
Confidence, that's all you need. All you need, Gary. All you need is one race win, trust me, and then confidence just flows.
Yeah, and then you never get then you never won't get one again. What happened to that Red Bull there, of Ricardo? Very, very slowly into the pit lane. He was going about 60 miles an hour into the pit lane before the limiter even took over there.
He actually spun it.
There's a problem. Yeah, there seemed to be a problem there. He was going very slowly out the last corner, and then he just didn't pick speed back up.
Well, that's a shame to see.
There is.
8 drivers
now. He was sick last week. I wonder what. Maybe he still could be still sick, but.
Well, to me, I thought he still lost his front wing because he dropped. He dropped.
No, he had a full front wing. Had a full front wing.
Didn't lose it in the final corner. He does leave the session. Disappointing to see, but never mind.
Yeah. Oh god, Jism's nearly spun at the tight left hander. He nearly with the curb. Well, he nearly went deep. Then the curb nearly spun him into the corner. It's a bit strange, but yeah. So that happened. Adam Lee is all over the back of MM Shots. Of course, MM Shots on those dead sort of 12 lap old primes. Compared to Adam's fresh ones, where he's gonna nip him now. There you go. He did the racing line and overtook him because Shots just went a little tad wide.
Jeremy's into the pit. Jeremy's into the pit. Big Venable goes past and now takes the lead on lap 13.
Will Adam Lee get the undercut? On Gary, anyway.
Probably not. Gary on options.
Oh.
Nice.
Jizz and Pitts.
I like that.
He's going for the
quick. I do like that.
He's going options.
The problem he's going to have, though, is that he's got to get ahead of his train.
He's ahead.
There's a long hit.
He's
going to adjust. And Adam Lee is one of those guys now needs to pull away.
He's set
fast as well. Absolutely critical that he sets fastest laps and pulls away from Adam, because all Adam needs to do is stick to him on primes. Although, saying that, he does have an illegal overtake penalty, probably that he's not aware of, but we are aware of, and you, the viewers, know that we're aware of, so he's effectively out of it.
Reminds me a lot of race 1. Yeah.
Either way, he'll be out of it unless he pulls away.
He will be leading
field.
The championship after this race, though.
Yeah, no
Bun's not
happens.
Here. Unless he doesn't finish, haha.
Unless he doesn't finish and Gary wins, then Gary will be leading the championship.
Oh, will he?
Yeah,
that'll
be
interesting.
Would
be. Yeah, crikey.
He would be. He's only 16 points behind Gary.
Ah.
God. Has he got a podium every race?
Well, Gary, no.
No.
He has.
Okay.
Big Animal Pit. From the lead of the race.
Oh, Gary! Crikey. In front, nearly dropped it. He nearly dropped it in front of Adam Lee. He's pushing.
There's nothing about this there. Got 40 laps. 40 laps to go.
Continue.
Big Animal options. Both on the same strategy. Where is Big Animal going to come out in regards to where everyone is? There goes Gary through. He's behind Gary and Adam Lee, so that kind of hasn't really worked out for me.
Blake's going to pass MM Shots.
Blake.
He's got him, you would think. Traction, better grip, definitely.
There you go,
yeah. There you go. He needed to do that. Shots isn't going to try anything. I wouldn't. He thought about it. No.
Thought about it, yeah.
He thought about it, but he was very cautious whilst thinking. He did sort of break quite early and very hard. Once he realised it's not going to work and not worth it. Ricardo sent me a message, so this is probably why he retired. Got bored. Ah, not what I expected.
Okay, that's
really not what I expected.
What lap did he retire?
12.
Okay. Draco's winning, by the way. I don't know if we've said that.
Yep. Draco is winning.
Right. Hasn't pitted yet.
No, he hasn't, but casual, isn't he, right now? So what's happening with Adam Lee? Is he being absolutely murdered? Yes, he is. By a tube animal.
Yeah, this is what tube animal needs to do.
Pass him.
Pass and get the gap.
And get to Gary.
For the inside before the final corner. Is Adam going to even try and bite? He is.
Tube needs to get to Gary.
He's got that.
So now we've got Tube catching Gary. Tube's going to go get Gary. I don't even know what I said to win the button, but then he's not going to. Don't even know what the rest of it was. What was it? Second? Did I get second, third, fourth, fifth?
You had Tube second, Adam third, Gary fourth, Jizz and fifth.
Okay.
I know I did say earlier in the footage that Gary did have fastest lap, and I do believe he does now have the fastest lap with a 134.417. Am I right in saying that?
Yeah, it looks like it. Yep. He's got the fastest lap by a tenth to Adam Lee.
Only a 34.4 though, that's...
Yeah, but that's only his first lap. Really on those tyres, he couldn't get... I see what you're meaning, though.
He's got to be in the 33s at least.
But then again, Tube's just jumped on them as well, so we're going to see what he's going to do. And his are two laps faster than Gary's. The reason I say it is because the two.
To keep with them and to effectively be in front when it's all said and done is to keep with them and doing consistent lap times, and I think he's doing just that.
Gary has pulled a big gap actually from Adam.
That would be expected. Oh, Adam! Whoa! He went
hit the bollard.
Yeah.
He killed. That bollard's not too scary compared to the last one and the first one.
Yeah, I was expecting, as soon as he hit it, to be destroyed car, but thankfully for him, that is not one of them.
It's not as bad as that, though. You can hit the bollards and get away with it. It's sometimes. Oh, this is going to be a fast lap Tube. Tube's on a 33.9. What did Gary do?
Yeah.
What did Gary do?
Gary's on a 34.3, mate. It was a fastest lap until Tube crossed the line.
Yeah, you see what Tube is doing, that's the lap times you need to do.
He's done four tenths quicker. 4 tenths quicker on that lap.
Yeah, Adam Lee did a 34.9 on his prime, so he's keeping with him, that's all he needs to do. Blake Emery's actually catching up to Adam.
He's a second slower than Tube on that last lap. So I wouldn't put that down to keeping really with him.
He's keeping enough. The options are a lot faster, especially on the end of the race. I mean, you could be going into 32s on option tyres.
Or maybe 31s.
Gary's on the back of Draco, I think.
I think he's nearly beyond him in two corners. Nope, still hasn't. On options as well. So you would think they'd trench today.
Well, that's the strategy that Andy for Andy did to win the F1 race earlier this week. A fantastic victory. Watching that, I was cheering him on and everything, won it by 17 seconds, a commanding victory. Joe got third, which, reasonable result, but he still hasn't won yet this season. I know you keep on reminding him about that, Wes.
I know, sorry about that to him, but, the one that everyone thought was going to win, not doing it. Oh, Drake is pitting.
He'll win at China. If he doesn't win at China, there's something wrong.
No, I don't know if he's racing at China, though. Drake, I did pit now.
No, he isn't.
Well, I don't know if he is or not, he's not sure, because he doesn't know what's happening in the next week, because of uni. I'm not sure if we should write this down, but Draco cut the pit lane entrance. He went across the white line.
He
went across the white line. Not seriously, but he went across it. I'm not sure how strict...
Straight across.
Well, he went from being on the racing line to he decided, halfway across... Oh, God. Where the hell is that?
That is a weird one. That is a really weird one.
It's the first ever time I get to use the yellow flag, but I thought Gary destroyed his vehicle on the bollard then. Safety car, first safety car of the season.
That is a really, really weird one.
I'm shocked.
It's weird because even if he'd done that on purpose,
His dot was on the red line.
My guess is that he's got too much on the curb on the outside and it's spat him off to the left, which I've never seen anybody do, but I can understand.
Well, actually, that's a good point. Yeah, that's happened. I know that's happened.
Yeah, I've got stuck in that curve and everything is spot about off to the left, so...
Well, I'm looking at the map and I'm going to see exactly where it would be if it was the red line.
Yeah, what about there?
Maybe the pit lane wall.
No, it can't be the...
Yeah, he is, right, Gary? Yeah, Gary's in, and yeah, so's Tube.
Adam Lee isn't.
Neither is Blake.
That could be a mistake.
I'm not sure.
That is definitely a mistake, guys.
But they're on prime though. They're on prime, and they're gonna have to keep their stint going if they want to do what they want to do. They want to stick to their strategy. I'm like, Gary's going for. Oh, he's gone on prime.
Yeah, he's getting them primes out of the way, and then he'll do a double option stint. Oh.
Gary split his strategy. Why has he changed?
Adam Lee was close to hitting the safety car.
Tube and Gary both have changed their strategy to go jump on the prime quick. And that's put Draco fourth, because he's only just pitted for some options on that last lap.
Yeah, shots pitted, so they're all sort of pitted. I don't agree with that, because how many laps were they on options before the safety car came out? Only three?
Well, Gary was on five, and I think Tube was on three.
Unless, in my experience of a safety car, you only do it if that is your scheduled stop.
Yeah, if you're near your scheduled stop by like two laps, then you're like, okay, I can.
There really is no point in pitting three laps into your stint.
I can see where Gary's going. I mean, like, if he didn't have the safety car, he would have to finish the race on primes, whereas now he's sort of covered the manoeuvre, he can now put options on and battle Adam to the end.
Message
from Johnny Pop. More speed map pulled me towards the barrier.
He is on a wheel, just saying.
He is on a wheel, so that is understand.
The wheel problem.
Pad power. God, how many times
pad. You sound like a woman there.
How many times do I have to say it?
They like using wheels because they feel like they're properly racing, which I don't blame them for.
Disconnect.
So do controllers if you run out of batteries.
No, but wired controllers.
Yeah, but I don't, so.
Wired batteries. Controllers. You're not gonna.
No. Because I could still disconnect. The wire comes loose.
But all the leaders are on prime.
Blake's gonna pit, isn't he?
Blake's gonna pit.
So is Adam.
Adam pits as well. Oh, that was a late call. Very, very late call. It's going to give Gary the lead again. What are they going to go on?
Oh, probably options. They've changed their strategy.
Primes for Blake.
No options for Adam. He's been held up.
Wow.
He's changed his strategy. He's changed his strategy.
How many times going to tell them? Stick to your strategy.
So now what? How many laps are you going on those options? I know he's gone on prime, so he doesn't have to go on prime again for the rest of the race, but...
We are down to seven. Seven drivers left in this race.
What's his tactic? Tactic of just randomly go on options when the others die and try and get to the end. That's his tactic. And Blake's gone back on the prime. I don't exactly understand why he went back on the prime. He was already on prime. He's made his stop go a little bit longer, but I don't know when the hell primes go. Probably 20 laps?
I'll tell you something actually, after this race. Looking at it. Fun Dance, I believe you may have a few drivers that might be interested in joining this.
Okay.
I believe so.
Yep.
I did request it to.
I don't know what you guys are talking about now.
Australia. But for obvious reasons, because only six finished there, and 10 started. I think it's needed.
Don't worry. Azos says
Gary should do one more stop.
Then go for another prime stint.
When you say 30th, but 20 laps from now is near 40, he takes them to 38, they got, 19 laps to do around about it.
If you want to do another option,
maybe does two primes.
If you want to do another option stint from here, go to lap 40.
He's waiting them up.
Gary's really holding them up. Wow.
Contact the guy.
Is in on this lap. I think the man to watch is Draco. He can take the lead here on his fresh options if he can get a good run on Gary, who's weaving about a lot.
The safety car's not going very quickly away from him, so I don't blame him for this.
Turned himself, so here we go. Racing back on the way. As he's going to start lap 20. That is a good restart, actually.
Oh, the safety car's going across the white line as well.
Gary, no! Slow down! Oh.
I bet it's... No, it's braked him. It's braked him because the safety car only just got in the pit lane.
Yeah,
that's why.
I said it was a good restart. Maybe it wasn't. Draco takes the lead.
Jism's just going to fourth.
Oh, my God, grief.
Oh, Gary.
He's done it again. He's done
unlucky
it again.
Unlucky, that was unlucky on Gary.
I
would not have expected that.
Is it?
He'll be fuming.
I'm just thinking as well. I don't think he's ever done a safety car restart, has he?
I think he has. I'm sure he has. Jism's on him though. Jism's in fourth.
And Draco leaves the race. With Tubanimal in second, the tube is sticking to him on those prime tyres. Gary's going to be absolutely frustrated with himself. Now in third, he's got to come back. Jism is fourth place. Ridiculous. Animal, he's got to get off the field and he's shoving Blake wide.
No, that was Blake, I think, misses brakes, hit the back of the Ferrari, then Adam managed to slot through and he's also passed shots at the same time, so he's passed two cars in one there.
Wow. Great double overtake there by Adam.
Last shot's gone deep.
Whole tyres for pretty much everybody at this point. See what that safety car has done is brought Jism back into the midfield of this race.
Come on, Draco there. Into it as well.
Oh my God.
It's put Draco in the lead.
Oh, Tubanimal clobbered the bollard in the final corner.
Oh, Jism guy went wide again, just like he does in quali. Well, did in quali, so not does, did.
All about the least amount of stakes here we could be.
Yeah, it is. Welcome to GP3.
Mistakes,
yeah.
I'm now hungry for a steak.
Oh,
you're hungry, mate. That's what I think it is, mate. You want a steak for your dinner?
That's what you want.
I had a curry already.
I was about to say, you've gone from posh to be not being posh in one sentence, though.
I know. I'll tell you what, Jism is
want a
right
steak,
in the back
where
of
no,
Gary.
I had a curry.
Right in the back of Gary.
He is.
The two leaders are right ahead as well. It's a very much Gary interesting line. And again.
Tubanimal must be one of the favourites to win this now, being on the prime.
There's still a long way to go though.
He is fighting Draco, he is fighting the guy on options ahead, and he's still being held up by Gary, really. Jism misses brakes and Adam's going to nick him, you would think, on traction, there you go.
Yeah.
Adam goes to fourth. Now that's not what Gary wanted.
Adam's on prime, isn't he?
Adam's on option.
Oh, he's on option, yeah, of course.
Gary's on prime.
But then again, Adam doesn't have to pit again for prime.
Adam needs to be in the position where Draco is.
Yeah, that's why he's trying to get there. Yeah.
Trying desperately to get there, but Draco, Vizzini, has ever still in the lead. Adam is now going to be right behind Gary. Safety cars really spiced up this race indeed.
Gary's not at the best corner. Oh!
The curves have interrupted Adam. Going into the slipstream now. Surely this is going to be an easy pass.
Yeah.
He's into the lead. Can Tubanimal get past Draco's?
Gary's misses brakes and decided they were going to lunge for the move.
Ooh.
They luckily escaped that, I would say, and Adam's just going to stay ahead. You can see on the braking.
Turn four.
That's ahead of me.
Draco. Come on, Draco, defend this. You got the grip. Yep, right on the outside. Come on, keep it. There you go. Oh.
Yeah, Gary seemed to miss his brakes a little bit, then tried to avoid him and go to the inside. Then Adam sort of covered him off and they slightly tapped in the apex of the corner, but they got away with that.
Interesting now, because how many stops are these guys going to make?
Gary's going to technically make four, because he pitted under the safety car, same with Tube, but then they'll technically make four, but...
It was Adam and Blake, really.
Oh yeah, that's
another
true.
Another two stops, would you say from here? Could potentially do a one.
Probably for Adam. If he goes option option,
one, if you go
I think
right
he can. Yeah. I know that. I feel like Draco's going to do one more. of how long he went on his first options. He's still got primes to go.
He doesn't have really the pace. Two
animals join up beside him here. Come up to the last bend.
Keep an eye on options. He can't hold them back.
He's got the
control.
And he'll get DRS as well.
Keep on hitting that curb.
Now this should be tubes. Not opening the DRS. Stand by that. Must be broke.
Adam Lee's behind them. Adam Lee's behind the
pair. He's not using his either. Why is no one seeming to use the DRS now? Tube's got that.
By tubes. He held, took him to the, take the lead.
Jism's battling with Gary as well.
Gary. Yeah, in the background, yeah.
Battles all
didn't
over
get past.
Even Blake and I think the Ferrari of shots is still in the battle there at the back. Ridiculous how the safety car can change everything.
Fine, always spice up the races, always good racing. Adam is a much more comfortable than these two ahead of him. He would want to get rid of Draco as soon as possible to get to tube. Then get clear air. Chisholm's on options.
He's been held up from Gary, really.
I think all of them pitted under the safety car, and Seth and Draco. Thinking, yeah, you've got away with that one for that one, because that was less of one. I'm not sure if that actually was.
Yeah, that's an exact game of time.
He didn't even pass anyway.
In line by two.
Stays behind Draco anyway. But Draco pitted the lap before the safety car, so he's the only one that really didn't pit under the safety car. And Adam's going to get him. Oh, no, he's not. Bad traction.
He tapped the back of Draco as he tried to pass him.
No, not his face.
Oh, Adam, come on.
But he wasn't going to get him anyway. He was always going to have DRS. I
hate it when people do that. Really hate it.
It's a good tactic. There you go, Adam will go through.
Still don't like it when people do that. But never mind, Adam
it's
is
a smart tactic. He wasn't going
to
get past him on the final corner anyway. Oh god, there goes
Chisholm.
He wouldn't have. He may have had the inside, but he wasn't really alongside, so he would have braked any sooner anyway.
Possibly, but I don't know.
It gave him a better run out of the exit if he did that, because he didn't have a car on the racing line next to him. Gave him more of the track to use. Gary's now on the back of Draco. People behind are still sort of fighting.
20, isn't it?
Yes.
We're thinking that the safety car hasn't really helped out Adam because it's closed everybody down.
Yeah, it hasn't until now.
20 seconds will put him back a lot. Gary's on the back of Draco. Looking for the inside. That is going to be an interesting move. He pulls up, goes under, swing wide. Draco gives him just enough room. Ooh.
You say Draco gives him just enough room. He was left just enough room, really, from Chisholm, from Gary in the first place, as he understeered into him.
Adam Lee's driving up on Tube Animal on the last bend. He's giving a little nudge. He's still okay, he's still there.
He managed to just caught out by his braking, and Adam Lee.
The other side straight.
33.7, improving his personal best lap, goes through into the lead.
The fast lap of the racing as well, I believe that will be.
Yep.
What he had to do.
Everyone seems to have a later braking. You could see that just as they hit the brakes. Everyone seems to have a later braking than everybody else. It's really weird.
Well, the three-way battle for third here between Draco Fire,
Gary and Chisholm.
Yep.
Hey, what, guys?
Message just coming in.
Anybody's guess now.
Yeah, it is. Has been the whole time. Gary's going to go a bit deep. Jism's going to try and get it oversteer.
No. For that one.
He's on him. Gary's got to look both ways.
Podium's anybody's guess, considering Adam's got that illegal overtake penalty hanging over him.
Then again, the wind is anyone's guess because they get close enough to choose. Love that has to go in the Gary Targe, so the speed demon. He has a Belgian last season. There you go. Matty says that last season in Belgium in F5000, he did a safety car start. Can you please tell Michael to shut up if you choose not to pass someone at a particular corner so that you can get an easy opportunity with DRS? That is all part of racecraft.
Who said that?
Speed Demon.
Yeah, cause Speed Demon does that.
A good tactic, you don't do it. How many wins have you got?
One.
Exactly.
Uh-huh.
Oh, we've got
Jism right there. Jism did it as well. Are you going to hate Jism now, Michael, because Jism did it? It's a good tactic. It's a smarter tactic.
I just think personally it's a cheap tactic.
DRS is a cheap tactic. Oh, Jism. That was weird. God, he sort of... I hate saying his name like that. He, I don't know, he turned back to the racing line and then I think he turned a bit too much and caught the curb and just locked up on the... I think that's the second time I've seen him do that now, this race.
The only reason I don't like it is because one particular person who I did not like used it on me in the final corner of a long race and beat me by a thousandth of a second over a line. The only reason I don't like it.
Should have geared up sooner.
Blake got on the inside of shots. He tried to get the maneuver off. He didn't.
Are they still fighting back there?
Okay. Whoa, Gary, nice line. Cutting right over the hairpin there.
Oh, God!
What happened there?
What the hell?
What?
Shots went under the bloody bollard, and then it changed the camera angle for me and put him under the damn track.
Okay.
What the bloody hell? His car's fine.
Is that a secret part that we don't know about?
Apparently. Bloody hell, that scared me. I was expecting it to come up with a destroyed vehicle then, because it was under the track.
Should have done technically.
Bloody hell. I want to do that again. Everyone on stream will just see a... Oh, God. Watch that back later, Michael, on that 26. Gosh, that was crazy.
The one person actually this is hurt.
Blake's through again.
Blake, he's right in the back of the field now.
He's still fighting with Shots, and it's not over yet, because Shots is on the options, by the way, so I don't... The fact that they're just fighting. Just continuously fighting, and they'll go off. Turn 4, I call this, because there's a little 3, and Shots is going to stay ahead. My messages seem to have a delay out of them at the moment. They seem to be coming in and freeze.
Gary was already past Draco. Already past Draco, a lap or two ago.
I think I just got a message from Button, or my messages are being responded. Yeah, I noticed that. I didn't see the overtake, actually.
I didn't see it, mate.
Yeah. No, I didn't see it either. Why you were
right.
Going about blatant shots. Why the double left is not very good.
Michael, how many seasons have you done? That's a question from Matty. How many seasons have you done?
Wow, this is my 4th, I think.
There you go. Azar says, imagine backing off the DRS to reverse over the line while swearing. That's one from Joe.
Right.
I'm not sure if that was an aim at you or Crazy Fish with the reversing bit.
It's an aim at everybody. He doesn't like concentration camp rules. I have to stab back at him, so...
Joe, are you Jewish, Joe? That's my question now.
Draco,
DRS
in the back of Gary. Simple.
Got him. Simple dimple.
Nicely done.
Very nicely done by Draco. He's got his option tyres, though. He still needs to pull away from Gary if he wants to beat him in the later run of the race. Still, we're just under halfway. We're at the halfway point.
This is where I say the pitting under the safety car will really, really kick in, guys. You will see the guys that didn't pit will pit in the next couple of laps, and the guys that did, they will go for a lot further, and that's where they're going to build up their time for another pit stop.
It was Adam and Blake, wasn't it?
And I'm sure Gary did as well.
Everybody did. Everybody pitted but Draco, because he pitted a lap before. Gary! Oh no, he's reversed it! He reversed it! Oh, he's been...
My God.
He reversed it. He reversed it, the imbecile.
Oh, dear.
He's down to last. That's a Gary moment for you.
Oh, dear.
That would have been a great move, because he got given the run by Draco until he put it in reverse.
Oh, that's my prediction out the window.
And that's... I do first gear sometimes.
That's funny.
But
that's funny.
Gear too often.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jism versus Draco for the damn podium. Let's get excited.
Yes. I think that's a classic example, guys, when Mario Kart doesn't work.
Yeah, when you put it in reverse. Oh, I can't wait for the messages for that one.
He's done it twice now, didn't he? And Demerick on the final lap.
Yeah, he did, yeah. That was hilarious.
On the DRS. Wow.
Oh, God, that was close.
Hit him.
That was so close. Oh, he didn't hit him, but Jism's in the third. Oh, I'm happy I'm watching this. He said to me that he'd get... He said to tell me to get, put him in fifth, and if he gets third, he's going to apologise to me. So at this rate, I'm going to get an apology later.
I put Jism for third. Come on, Jism, you can do this. 2 points. Yes.
Damn.
And I believe the very first podium I've ever had to interview him, and it'll be my last interview. Come on, Jism. Do this. Oh yeah, just to note anybody that may be concerned that I won't be commentating again, if there is anybody. I might do it. I'll do it if anybody needs me throughout this season, but it won't be a main thing. Main topic.
Same me.
not blaming you, it's alright.
No, I said same with me because of work. I'm going to do as much as I can.
Pit stops coming up soon, guys. The option time looks like they're going. About a second and a half now difference.
Is he?
Battle isn't over for the podium. Draco is sticking to Jism. That is...
They're on pretty much the same tyre life as well.
Adam's going in the pits. What tyres are you taking?
Could be another set of options. Could be primes. Wow, Jism. Come on.
He turned in too early. That didn't game him anything. He hates it when someone's behind him. You're seeing that here because I think Drake will be in front of him by the end of this straight.
He's already
done prime, so I think he'll just keep going options till the end.
I think this is in the end of the race now, mate. No more pits to run.
Really?
No,
27 laps,
27
not
laps.
Happening.
No.
Not happening.
Primes, maybe.
One more.
God, can you imagine if he did that? Joe's actually crying at the fact that Gary did that.
Oh, God.
I think they all are.
I'm crying.
Quite funny to watch.
He could have won the race. He could have.
He just said he is the. He's just said on the Facebook chat he is the gift that keeps giving. He really is. It's fantastic to watch Gary sometimes.
Yeah, as I was saying, I'm only gonna. Commentary will become a main thing for me only if we do another season, and only if somebody is streaming.
I think it's
very likely we'll be doing another season. I don't know yet, but
don't know about the streaming bit though.
As for the streaming bit, I'm very unlikely unless Chris.
It was very unlikely I'll be doing this one, and then
unless Chris wants to do it full time.
Unless Chris wants to do it for you, don't you?
I must admit though, Gary having an accident has let Blake get in.
Yes, it's brung him back, innit? He's fifth now. I don't know why I pressed that button to look at messages, but I have only two have come through after my whole message has been respawned. Actually, technically one. There's another one for the Gary Targe.
The Gary Targe.
Definitely so. Definitely the Gary Targe. It's fantastic how many mistakes you can make. He's the one at the back.
Oh, is he there?
No, Blake's at the back, I think, yeah. I think he pitted. Well, afterwards, shots comes back at him. That was good.
Very good. I think it was Maurizio Riva Bene speech. I said to him that they'd be fuming. He's doing it, mate. Going for it.
Fighting. Right? Oh, no, God.
I think Shots is going to end up in fourth tonight.
Shots does have the 10-second in-game penalty and I think a 20-second from us before.
Yeah, from the last race.
Sadly, so that's not helping him. Yeah, sorry about that. That's not helping him too much.
A minute from 1 point in the last season.
Yeah, near the end, yeah. That was exciting. A little while. Oh, that's an understeer. That's Blake gone off. Yeah, he decided to pit, don't blame him. Adam Lee's going to pass Blake. Blake went deep into the left-hander. There you go. Adam into fifth.
I'm going to say this right now. Gary's going to win the race from here. He'll need a safety car.
Yeah. Definitely.
And even if that happens, I don't think,
I think hitting that into reverse is definitely costing, mate, big time.
It's the highlight of this race. Other than the safe guard, that's the highlight of this race.
I can't believe it.
Just the fact that we were on board of him, and it looked funny. And it was Gary.
I wasn't aboard of him. Jizz and Pits.
Adam Lee's going to go into fourth. Well, technically third now.
Wait.
Well, Jism was in third, but now Adam Lee's in third because he just passed MM Shots with DRS. Oh, Shots!
Adam
doesn't do anything. Those tires are gone! Oh my god, Shots! Whoa, ho, ho. Ho, ho, ho. Nice save. Nice save. And Jism goes back onto options.
So Adam and
he's
Adam
still
just not out of this race win. Well, before
no,
Stewart's come in.
No, because Tube's still got a pit at some point.
Before Stewart's come into this, obviously.
Of course, yes. And of course, there's Draco as well, which he's on a different strategy to everybody.
And of course, there's always a chance of another safety car before the end. That's ridiculous.
Of
course, you must remember F5000 from last season. That was ridiculous. A safety car that took out the championship leader and the leader of the race. And he had it comfortably. I think it was one of the Saubers, wasn't it? Into turn one.
Where
you are there?
I am here.
What you would reply?
Was this Gary?
No, I don't think it was Gary. It was a Sauber, I remember that.
Sauber, what track, sorry?
Bahrain, last season, F5000. Winning the race comfortably and hit the
bird is the word.
One flipped in the air.
No, God, yes, bird is the word. I think bird is the word. Well, I know he destroyed his vehicle on it, but that was great to watch and look at. I screenshot it on.
I think Shots was the other one.
A lot of them did it. Yeah, I think it might have been Shots. One of I know it was crazy. Well, Shots had already hit the bollard this week and well, this race and gone under the damn track, so
doesn't know how he's still running.
I don't know. Maybe it, was, it literally changed my camera angle.
Adam's on
that's
the back of Draco. Much fresher tyres at this point.
Outside.
Go around the outside of the
oh, this will be good.
Hand.
This will be good.
Oh,
he's just gone over. He's just
wheel.
Gone over.
No.
Yeah, he's gone over.
Oh dear, oh dear.
Oh, that's a little one. He doesn't get the luck for those, does he?
That's the same corner on the same person.
Yep. Yeah, it is. I think wow. I Mario Kart everywhere, says Matty. Love you, but in reserve. Love,
yes, I know.
Love a
do.
Bit more. I love a bit more how Gary goes. How Gary got pushed while he was ghosting as well. Yeah. He got pushed whilst he was ghost as well. That's see, I've seen that happen before where it's destroyed vehicles because I can't remember what race it was now. Australia, no, not the Minister, you know, actual league race. America. In GP3, Draco Pitts, there was a crash at
I
turn
want that back. I'm saying it now, I want that back. I want Demo Derby back.
Turn 3 at America. Oh, Blake's going to try and pass Shots. Shots tries to outbreak him, locks up, and I think that's Blake's. And it is. Blake goes into third gear, and America turn 3. Someone spun, and he ghosted, and the whole pack just drove through him, and he destroyed his vehicle, because I don't know why. So Gary got very lucky there. That can happen, so.
Shots had a little look at Blake.
Yeah, he's on board with that, it's true.
Yeah, he's thinking better of it, mate. I think he's waiting for the DRS. Always going up. Inside,
yeah.
Right
no. His grip's starting to die a little bit, but he's sticking with him.
This battle has been going on ever since the safety car.
Yes.
In.
Yes, it has. And that was a while ago.
I think it was lap 17, so 17 laps ago.
Here we go. Oh, wait.
No,
he saved it.
Oh.
Nice, where is he?
He's got it off, he's got the inside line to the next bend.
Wow.
Nice.
He first geared it to keep it on the track, but he's done it.
At least he didn't put it in reverse.
No, he didn't. No. Oh, wow, Blake's still on him now.
He backed off, Michael's going to kill him.
No, I don't mind that. I don't mind
what do you mean you don't mind? It's the same thing!
No.
He
no,
could have
no.
gone for the overtake there. It's exactly the same.
The thing I don't like is when you're side by side and could have passed you anyway.
For God's sake.
That's what I don't mind.
Blake hit the first.
I know. Yes.
Come on. Right in the apex. Nice. Sweet.
Oh, got me close.
Yeah, Joe, if you're still watching, speak.
Yeah, they're all watching.
Demo Derby back.
They're all watching because of Gary. They always do.
Yes. Oh
shots!
On the outside, he held it. He's
going to pull that off.
That's brilliant. That's brilliant. He's got it. No, that was fire. He's got it. It's fine. Don't hum, Michael. That was fine. That was fine.
The fact he moved right there and tapped into Blake. That's okay.
It's fine. Yeah, that was a great move. Oh, would you agree, son? That was flipping awesome.
Yeah, that was a fantastic move, mate. Definitely. But, I mean, he gave Blake a little touch, but didn't really...
Upstate. Oh, that's Blake for Draco. Carries on the back of him.
Oh, Blake. Oh. Blake returns the touch. At the net's corner there.
Oh, Gary.
What's happening behind us?
Gary. For the CRS on the home straight as well.
Can't overtake Gary. You
did Gary just cut the corner?
Yes, he did. On Draco. That's free.
On Draco at the same damn corner.
That is,
is that the only way people can pass him these days?
Yeah, legal overtake on exactly the same corner. Now Gary's done it to him. Wow. That's great. And
he's gone off.
Fantastic line.
Who put it here? Shots.
Hey, shots. Oh, Draco, you're going to break, aren't you? Of course you are. There you go.
Gary's gone one again.
I don't think he got DRS though, Blake, did he?
I don't think so. Let's see.
He did.
The Blake instead of Draco, so you can choose the colour, man.
Right, so that's lap 35. Another legal overtake.
But I'd say the gap between the leaders is decreasing. I'd say the option tyres from Adam are kicking in against Two Animals Primes. It's definitely closing the gap.
They're his oldest Primes as well, really, aren't they?
Yeah, he's due a pit stop soon, I must say. Definitely drew a pit stop. I'd say the gap has come down to at least, 10 seconds, if that. And if you calculate with the pit stop, roughly about 20 seconds, a bit longer. I think he's definitely getting in, Adam will get in front, and then I think he's got to push on. Try and build a lead for his last pit stop, so he can counteract that illegal overtake he did earlier in the race. So yeah, definitely, I think the option tyres are kicking in there, mate. Really starting to kick in.
Everybody spread out, sort of, close to battle on the track. There's not really a battle. It is Draco and Gary.
Yeah.
Fortunately, Gary now has an illegal overtake on his hands. God. And to think, that was such a long way to go before the finish of the race. And lap 14, we were all saying Gary could have taken the lead of the championship even if he'd won, and Adam not score any points, but... Here we are, 5th place.
I don't even remember my top 5 now. I know I put Paul first, but that doesn't count because I say Blake.
Button first, Tube Animal second, Adam third, Gary fourth, right. Jism fifth. It's not exactly working out at this point.
Gary fourth, then maybe. Jism fifth, probably not.
The only person that had Tube Animal for the win was I.
I was the best, yeah. I didn't have the second.
Eyes, I'm getting fed up with you getting this right. I really am. Every time he says the only person that's got this right, it's Eyes. Like, every single week, it's always Eyes that seems to get this right.
Yeah.
Screw you, Eyes. Screw you.
I think I'd say, even though this race is still 20 laps done, it's going to be Andy leading the table on that one, with Eyes in second. There seems to be a fight between them two. I think Andy's going to have a big lead after it, 8 points yesterday. Nobody has got it completely right.
The gap between the leaders is down to 6 seconds now. 6 seconds.
On that, I think.
I expect Duban will be coming in any lap soon, round about lap
4. I think Blake's pitting. Yeah, Blake's in.
Yep, Blake's in.
What's picking?
Is going on.
He's gone
for prime for Blake.
I think that could be the wrong decision myself.
Is that to the end? Is it 20 laps?
Possibly.
20, that's basically, yeah, that's to the end, I think. 20 lap. 19, 20, yeah. Kind of, I think. If my strategy, he has been on primes, he just came off him. My strategy would have been, nah, I can't do two options. I might have gone two options, I think. I would have started on the option, I would have gone prime for my second run, then there would have been a safety car. I wouldn't have pitted under the safety car. I would have stuck with it. I don't know why, but I just would have. And then I would have pitted for option, and then I think another option. That's how I would have gone. But I don't think anyone's actually done what I've just said. Except for maybe Draco.
I would have gone option, and then trying to finish on the primes.
Oh, really?
Better time myself to finish on. But if a safety car come out, I would definitely have gone in, mate. Personal experience, I've had plenty of races. When the safety cars come out and I've continued on and carried on, and two guys went in, and when they come out, we were to go in like a couple of laps later, and they was just gone, mate. They ended up winning the race by about 25, 30 seconds, and one of the guys in question was Real Reapers. So, yeah, I mean, I can honestly say, down that safety car thing, I would have gone in, mate, and put the tyres on. But, hey, dude.
Especially the only reason I would have stuck out is because I would have only been on them for probably two or three laps. Tire wear would have been perfectly fine.
Yeah.
Especially my tire wear is brilliant, so they, with being on them for five or three laps, I would have kept them on just because I don't like wasting.
Yeah, back to the race, guys. lap 39, shots coming up to the Schumacher turn. Sorry, at Bahrain. Schumacher turn. As you know, it's turn 1, 2, 3, Schumacher.
I literally did not know that, but hey.
Yeah, they named it after Eddie's accident, unfortunately.
Oh! Here we go.
He's got that.
You know, there's two drivers in this division that I would label under the people of too nice.
You say too nice, but then you moan when someone taps someone else, like shots tap somebody.
But no, it was an unnecessary tap. No, it was forceful, basically to tell Blake to, you know, give up on the position, otherwise we're gonna collide or something like that.
Yeah, but yeah, smart decision, because most likely there you would have.
Adam's closing down the gap here.
He is.
Now within 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Got a lap time, yep. 132.8.
What I mean by too nice is because they're afraid to collide with the particular person that's overtaking them, they let them through or don't really put that much of a fight. There's not anything wrong in that. It's just something that need to learn when to be aggressive, when not to be.
This is where the race is hot up, guys. Adam's now about to get the
RS. You've spoken about them being these two will be very aggressive on each other. Watch it.
Yeah.
This is for the race when you know it's going to be.
Adam is the only one in the 32s at the moment. Oh, 32 has been as fast as the lap. Whoa! Careful with the cars on the outside.
He'll wait,
I reckon. Maybe he wants to go for it. Oh, he's looking. He's going to wait for DRS, he won't try the other gear.
He's going to do the annoying thing, he's going to go right, and then he's going to brake, don't worry.
He went over the curb, though.
God's sake.
Did he cut that. The corner?
Yes, he cut that.
Yeah.
He cut that.
Yeah.
Oh, Adam, come on.
White line.
Don't want to be doing it.
Tube can repass him. Maybe. Yeah, he's not going to, though.
No.
God. Ah,
that's my God, Adam.
Getting unlucky there, isn't it?
Seems to be a thing.
Jism, though, on the podium, mate. Jism.
Oh, come on, Jism. This will be a race win for him. This will be second after everything, because Adam's got so much penalties in there. That'll be his best ever finish, I think, second. I know he's got third.
Illegal overtake this race.
Yeah, I know. So
we're not done yet.
Can I ask, or... Does Jism have any pennies coming into this race?
No.
Just
want to figure out how far he is from the leaders, because
doesn't have anything.
Right, so then definitely Tube Animal and Jism are definitely, I'd say, the favourites.
Yeah, I would. Put it this way, Adam has a minute worth of penalties.
Right, I did.
Because it's 20 seconds apiece for every illegal overtake. And he's got three of them.
Drivers won't know that, of course, but
they should realistically know. I mean, if you cut a corner,
I don't think they noticed. Draco wouldn't have noticed that Adam went wide on him,
no,
and he wouldn't have noticed. He probably might, yeah, but I don't know if he might. He hoped that we may not have seen it. Animal pits.
I mean, animal.
Is Jism gonna beat him out? I don't think so. Not is he? Is he?
He might do.
Oh, there's a long way to go still in the. Oh god, this is gonna be close.
No.
Is Jism gonna slow? Because technically he'd be in the lead. Jism will go into the technical lead. There he is.
My god.
Jeremy's in the pits as well.
Don't say my god, because we want this.
Jeremy's in the pits.
We want this bad.
He's still gonna pit another time, Wes. He can't take off from the end, whereas Tube.
Oh shit, Tube can. Oh crap, Tube can. Yeah, Tube can dead at the end.
Oh crap. You're very biased, aren't you?
I'm not being biased, it's just Tube's won a race, and Jism hasn't. There's a degree to me that like seeing drivers win their first race. I got excited when you did, I got excited when John Digweed did. And the rest of them as well. The rest that I can't remember.
Tubana was lucky that a. Oh yeah! Corner cutting! I forgot I was doing that.
What's the RS here?
I have been doing it, don't worry, I have been doing it. I just realised. Ooh.
He's about to be overtaken for second here.
No, he's not.
Him off. He's got to pit. He pits now, he's got a good chance to get the podium.
Two bit of gravel on the outside.
As you said, Adam's in the pit. Is he gonna? Yeah, he'll beat them out, surely, won't he?
His options as well. Yeah, Adam's put options on.
You gonna beat them out? Yeah, he'll beat them. Yeah, safe enough. And he'll be going to the end, and he wants. He's gonna need to get a gap, and he knows it. Of course, Jism's in the way of Tube, which is very helpful to Adam here.
I must say, with Tube being so close to Jism, coming up towards the middle sector, leading onto the back straight with
his Blake. Was this Blake? Turn one.
He's got it. Wait, no, he's not.
No, it's not. Traction.
Did he let him back through? Because that was very poor traction.
Massively poor traction, I don't
think. Very poor, which is weird, because that's where he's got fresh tyres on. And he has got fresh tyres on, so.
Up here, guys, at the front. So, Tube Animal about to get DRS here, and then, back straight. Jism cuts the corner.
Doesn't like pressure, does he?
No, he doesn't like cars behind him, he hates it.
And he's in such a high position as well.
Bad corner break one tonight, guys.
It is, yeah.
I don't really want to curse him, but I must say, I'm not yet. His shots, I think everyone has literally hit that corner.
Actually, here's the question, Wes. Has shots ever won a race?
No. No, he hasn't. He's got two podiums, I think.
Interesting. Oh! Close as you like between the pair of them. Tube Animal hit the bollard, I think. Jism really needs to pit the tyres. He's not going to get the end on these options, but he's pretty resilient. Up on the
inside.
Yeah, he's got it. Right, come on, Jim. You've got to pit next lap. Pit next lap. Box, box, box. Come on.
Blake Henry about to go in the fifth here. Past Draco. He makes the manoeuvre. He slows it down. Gets in the second. Nice. Through. Draco's coming back. hold on to the back of him until he gets to that back sector and get the DRS to kick in and bring him a bit closer to the home straight. And he's staying there. Give a little look. Definitely wait for DRS. He's gonna wait for DRS.
Oh! Adam Lee's gone very wide there. Who's gone the outside? Who's taking the lead? Who was taking the lead right on the outside? Adam went too far wide in that corner after the back straight long left-hander. But, onto the outside of the track and two panel was hit the bollard again. How has that not destroyed this vehicle? I have no idea, because I hit it at 20 miles an hour and destroyed it. And Adam Lee takes back the lead. Ooh.
Grab that bollard.
Wait, how many cuts is it for a 10 second penalty? 7 plus, isn't it?
I think it's 7 plus.
Interesting. Very interesting.
Five for a retina, I think it's 7 to 10, I think, for a 10. I'll be honest, I haven't read the rules. I really hate it when they go under that. Tube has the fresher tyres, doesn't he? Is he Adam? Adam. I think Adam does, doesn't he? Adam does by a lap, actually. My memory's gone.
Animal pitted on lap 43.
Adam has fresher tyres, because Adam only just pitted. Because Tube came out behind Jism first.
Come on, Jism, you're pitting. Yeah. You can do this.
God, my memory went for a second there.
Jism is in danger of losing his position. The shots, mate, the way it's going. Oh, pit done.
God's sake, you hit that bollard again.
I'm asking the bollard's not there anymore.
Happy with him.
See, on mine, the bollards are sort of given up trying to get back going. They just sort of die.
Jism pits. It's going to be crucial where he comes out. He's going to get a podium.
I don't want more.
Yeah, shots moved into third. He's just going to get out ahead of that train of cars there. Should be... Oh, he's going to come out straight in there. Oh, God, he's going to be on the freshest tyres of everyone. He's come out right in the middle of the pack. Oh, my God.
Back of it.
He's got the fastest tyres though.
Behind Gary, which is trying to get Draco.
Yeah, guys ahead of him are on primes.
Gary's on options.
Back up to the leaders, guys. You've got Tube Animal Weird drafting and DRS and Adam down the middle sector.
Gary's through. Gary passes Draco. Look?
Nice move. Come on, just go for it. No, don't break so early. Being biased now, I'm sorry.
I'm being biased.
Ism got past Draco. Draco going out. Oh my God, he went straight.
Wait,
Draco lost it. He's gone right on the outside though.
No. I hate to say something, man.
What? What?
I want to look that back. I want to write that down.
He's taking over in the last corner. Tube is coming up now about the DRS and down the home straight. Has he got enough to get down to turn one to get the lead? He has.
I think he has. It's a dive. No, he thinks better of it. No.
Yeah, that was smart. A bit of driving there as it goes. He could have gone in there and caused a lot of damage, but with so few laps to go, it wasn't worth it.
Ah. Sims is going to have DRS on the back of Draco. Decides not to use it for whatever reason, but he's going to get it anyway. Get past.
Yeah, did that thing before.
Oh! Whoa!
He's in the wall.
Oh. I don't know what happened there.
Damage
of
worth,
no. Gave him a slight tap, and that just put Draco off, I presume.
I'm not going to write that down. I think the room may have not been given enough. And definitely when he was overtaking, the room was there, but he may have squeezed him a bit on the grass.
Might squeeze him a little bit.
It's caused Draco damage as well. So we'll leave Crazy Fish to have a lot of problems tonight.
Yeah. Definitely leave the win up in the air.
I don't even know, we've got 10 to go. That one's a bit confusing. Well, some of them have been a very confusing tonight. Let me check if I've got any messages. Yes, I do.
What penalty is it for 10?
I believe that's either where it's still 10 seconds or it may turn to 20. I think it turns to a 20 at 11, I believe. Gary, DRS on Blake. Blake goes to defend. Gary goes to overtake for fourth place. He decides the outside's the better route. Goes to it. Got DRS. Brakes nicely. Is he going to be past Blake? Blake has a lag spike, so yes.
Aww.
Lucky for Gary.
And, yeah, lucky for Gary. Draco's now retired in the pit lane. In the pit lane. There's ages. There's not long to go. There was about 10 to go, and that was 7th place, which is 6 points quite nicely.
That's unfortunate.
They shouldn't really have retired. I could understand going in the pits and grabbing a new front wing and going again for the last 10 laps, but not retiring this close to the end.
Interesting now. This is interesting. I know something that you don't know.
See your face. I could probably work out what it is.
What? How much would you say the gap is between the top two and third?
I'm just trying to calculate now myself, mate. I'm looking at that.
Let me grab my stopwatch.
I'd say at least 25 seconds, mate, at least.
I'll work this out.
I think shots tires, looking at them, look really. I can see a line now.
Shots tires at shot.
Yes, those shots tires look shot, mate. I'm seeing a lot of lines on either side.
Right, my timer is going. I'll tell you when he gets there.
I think he's doing what I did last night, mate. Was a ridiculous idea of going long.
They are dead.
Long options. But, yeah, that's what I did, mate. My first set of tires last night took me too long.
Is it worth?
It's 20 seconds.
Ooh.
It's about 20 seconds.
Ooh. Yeah. He could, but he's losing time to the guys behind, and then you have to look at the guys behind.
He will probably need a pit, I think.
He's bringing them into the race, isn't he, really?
Yeah. He's got, think about it this way, he's got about 8 laps to go, and look how bad he's doing now.
Yeah, I mean, imagine.
Just imagine in 8 laps time.
Yeah, another 3 laps, so can you imagine it?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Got
so Gary will be third.
Okay, Gary, guys, I might actually tell you this. Might as well tell you this.
Oh god, Jism in the background, holy cow.
Mm-hmm. I might as well tell you this, basically.
Doesn't is Gary that, have a new overtake?
Oh no, he does, yeah. Oh,
and then
okay.
It's Blake, so god knows what's going on.
No, Blake doesn't.
No, I mean there's Blake after Gary, who's the next car.
Okay.
Which is the only one that seems not to have anything wrong at the moment.
Basically. So, apart from Shots' tyres are completely...
They're dying. They should pit, and he's not pitting, though.
Ridiculous.
Should have pitted right about 42-45, and he didn't. He just kept going.
Yeah.
I know that Gary keeps on going to 8th gear before the first turn.
That's saving quite a fuel there.
I never do that. Again.
I swear they don't have 8 gears, do they? These ones? I swear they're 7.
That is 8.
Eight now, yeah.
Wait, do these 2014 have 8?
So yeah, they do.
They have 7.
I swear, they don't have 8.
No,
seven,
it's 7. Because you don't go in 7th gear really on this game often.
Okay,
and next game it's 8th gear that you... Well, you go in 8th gear, but...
You better be ready to go in first.
Yeah.
Come on, Shots. Keep it going, buddy.
When did Gary pit? Oh, Gary likes
Not too long ago.
Flag.
Gary didn't put too long ago, I think. No, I think he'll be able to find it at the end.
Let's have a look. Actually, Shots has got a 10-second in-game penalty, in-game, so he's done. Gary's made four stops. Adam has made four stops. When did Gary pit? Let's have a look. Oh, God.
Back to the leaders, guys. Tube Animals just drafted up to Adam Leeds around turn one. He's got a good line. He's already up to him. This is very close, mate. This is all about DRS guys on each lap.
Lap 41 is when Gary pitted.
16, he'll be fine.
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Compared to Shots, he'll be fine.
Jism's still got the freshest tyres, though. By a mile. By an absolute mile, he's got the freshest tyres, but he can't use them at this point. There was a
podium God, look at the leaders.
Jism. There's a podium here. You've just got to go for it.
Both the leaders sliding.
Yeah. The leaders are going for it, mate. They're probably going for it. It's all about each lap. I'm working out who's going to get it on each lap.
DRS again for that tube animal. He won't be close enough to do anything here, but he's still being within range, he hopes, of the main straight, which is the one you want, really.
Yeah, that's the one you want, mate. That's that one, that back one, is just to keep you close, leading up to the back main straight. And it's the main straight, you've got to do your damage.
Really don't want... Don't really want to pass someone on the second straight, do you? Because then you're,
Just leaving yourself
screws
vulnerable
up.
For the straight for the DRS.
Yeah.
Well, that is a battleful podium, actually.
Michael's working stuff out in his head, but he's saying it out loud, don't worry about it.
I'm working it out in my head.
But saying it out loud.
It's something that you don't.
No, because we know that Tube Animal has a corner cutting penalty, because you've been so obvious about it.
Yeah, but do you know how much he's got?
He's having a look. 34 20.
Adam's gone wide. Tube's gonna get him. Tube will get him.
Inside, he's got a better grip. Oh, they come close, but no touch.
You sound like Button now.
Noise is.
That's a cutback, no, Adam.
They're still going. They're still going. No damage.
That's good. Adam went for the think a little cutback there, but Tube was well parked nicely. What's happening here?
This is it. This is when the
Jism, Jism's just passed Blake for fifth.
Just passed Blake. Come on,
that was
man.
A nice DRS. You got
this.
Easy for me to get back to the lead as well. All I need to do is press one button on a straight back to it. So I'm quite happy with that.
Jism's got passed Blake on the inside.
Adam's having a look
come
at
on.
The DRS.
Come on, man.
Through.
You got this now.
He is. Outside. Oh, he's through.
Tube's let him have it. Tube's full smarter. He's
yeah.
He's got the DRS on the home straight, mate. Good smart driving now.
Right, Jism. Oh. It's your opportunity now. I'm being horribly biased. I don't care at this point. I want him to get a podium. I think he's got it. I think he can go for it. He's got the freshest tyres by a mile than the guys ahead of him.
I think Adam Lee will stay ahead of this DRS room, I think. Oh, Tube's not even using it.
Oh.
Okay. I'm definitely correct now.
Yeah, I can see the thing there, but I can't see him opening up his DRS.
Yeah. Maybe it broke. Won't be the first time this race, I don't think.
Looking at
them,
who's got the better tyres? I mean,
yeah, Adam has the one lap fresher. I know that, but they seem to be a bit even when it comes to actually how dead they are.
That was interesting and funny to watch there. All three Shots, Gary and Jism went wide in the final corner, and they almost half spun, and they had to react in time. That was brilliant.
Tube's on him.
Carbon copy.
Oh, Tube's teasing. Oh, that's okay.
He didn't get the best exit.
He didn't get the best exit, but he just managed to keep that DRS.
Oh, so now he opens it. Okay.
Yeah.
Weird one.
I wonder if he was thinking about breaking at the end of turn one, Wes, to save a bit of the time.
Maybe. Maybe.
Oh.
He's definitely seeming to think tactical, isn't he? That's,
yeah.
He's definitely...
He's doing everything right. I think he's definitely going for the win in this one. True, he's definitely doing everything right to win.
He's counting the laps down, you can tell. He's trying to think when to pass him because he doesn't want to be repassed before the end of the race.
Yeah. So we're coming up to now lap 54 and he's going to get DRS on this lap, which should get him the lead if he uses it. He does use it. He's now drafting Adam down the home straight.
Shots, his tyres are now gone.
His path, he's slowing it down. Will he overshoot the bend? No. No, good driving. He managed to take the first. He's gone around turn two. Yeah, he's away.
He's got that, yeah. It's Adam's turn this lap, really, with the DRS. Nothing's going to happen, you were saying, the midfield, maybe. What's happening there?
No, they're good. It's a bit like the fox and the hand, dude. Who's chasing who, do you know what I mean? Who's going after it? one of them's the fox, and the next one's got to take turns of being the fox, you know what I mean? Just keep taking turns every lap.
Oh.
What's the game? Duck, duck, goose. Well, it feels like right now. Tapping each other on the head and chasing each other.
My God, I can't believe this.
You can't believe that shot's up. Oh, yeah, I see that.
That could be that.
That's it, with three laps to go, you'd have to say it's definitely tubes. Depending on what penny might have accumulated throughout the race, I'm not sure about that.
Right. Three-way battle for the podium, guys. You're going to have to be on this.
I'm on it now.
Tyres are completely gone.
Gary's going for a pass, we think. He's going for a...
Gary's got the inside.
That was close.
It was just.
Got DRS. Surely he's going to have to go for it.
Chisholm as well. Remember, Chisholm's on the freshest tyres here. Out of all these guys here, Chisholm's got the best tyres.
Oh, shot!
Chisholm's tyres is gone.
Shot sideways. Chisholm on the inside.
Oh, lucky shot. Chisholm's gone up.
Got it.
Tell you what, Chisholm could be a good chance.
He's on here for a podium.
Oh, God. What?
Shot myself. Gary's got a legal overtake penalty.
Yeah, Gary's got a legal overtake penalty. So is Adam. And I'm not
sure. Adam's got a minute. Adam's got a minute worth of penalties on anyway. So he's out of it.
Jism
he's at the back.
Could he win this, could he? Could Jism not win this?
No, I think Tuvan was too far ahead.
The gap's too much. The gap's too much for Tube. I would say, I'm saying now, Tuvan has done 11 corner cuts in 3 laps. Oh, no, Jism.
Oh, Jism. He's gone off.
Oh no.
And now he's got to get back past shots.
Yeah, two animals got 11 and 3 laps. So that's a 20-second penalty, isn't it?
I think it's 10. I think that's 11. I think 11 is 10. 11 is 20, I think. But I think he's still. He's got a big enough gap to be ahead of this lot. So I think he'll keep the win.
He's got a big enough. So Gary's got a 20-second penalty for a legal overtake. So that's going to put him to the back
anyway.
Put
him behind this lot. Yeah.
So this is the podium. Well, after all the stewards have done, but
so it's shots versus Jism for the podium.
I feel sorry for shots, mate. I think if he just pitted on lap a couple of laps earlier than when he did, after when he did, I think he would have done all right, mate.
But to be fair, right now he's still within the podium if we put all the penalties on.
This is the second, effectively. Although they have no idea.
Yeah.
Remember in the
and there's two really to go, and these tyres have got to last that long.
To be quiet about it.
Chisholm behind them as well, and I think Blake's catching up behind
as well. Blake's there on the primes. Shots is there. Oh, Jason's breaking. He's going to get DRS.
He knows
Shots
fires is gone. He knows Shots fires is gone.
How on earth?
There you go. Joe tells me 11 corner cuts is still 10 seconds apparently.
Oh.
So he's Tube's definitely fine. Jism's in the fourth.
Fine.
Thank you, Joe.
Jism's through there.
Nice and clean. He's got those freshest tyres on. So he should effectively catch Gary up as well.
He could still catch Gary outright, actually.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking with the two lots of DRS. He can definitely catch Gary.
Just be careful, Jism. Come on.
He doesn't need a mistake or anything.
Oh, God, shots.
Oh, my God, shots. Tyres are absolute. So
dead. They're gone. They're absolutely gone. They're off the cliff now.
I feel for him.
They're off the cliff.
I've been in that place before. Got no grip.
Got no rear end grip. Look at him. Blake will pass him. Surely.
If Blake gets past shots, that's for the third place in the podium. Not that they know about it.
Oh, yeah, you've got to get him, surely.
He's fishtailing up out every corner.
He must have it in lean mix now for the corners.
No, I would.
I don't think he does.
Blake was there. He was there.
No. Oh, unlucky.
Blake was there, and I don't think they actually touched.
No, they didn't, mate. That was they didn't, there you go. Shots. That was a bit of a
meanwhile, two animals on the final lap. Yeah, Blake's now into that post. Come on. And it's 2 points for me.
It's the last lap and Shots will have the DRS, remember, and Blake as well in this last straight.
Chisholm
have it on Gary.
Come on, you can do this. You can do this, Chisholm, come on.
No biased opinions here in the commentary box, alright.
No biased opinions, I don't care. I don't care anymore.
Chisholm's going for it.
Go for it. Oh, dive on the inside.
Oh.
Gary's just about holding on for it. Oh, unbelievable.
Tacking back on the inside.
Go on, you can still, be there.
You can still go.
Stop being biased.
I don't care.
Will he go for it? He has.
Still there.
Side by side, ridiculous.
But remember, he's got the freshest tyres, Mick. He's got the freshest
tyres. Oh, come
on.
Think of it this way, guys.
Oh, he's not had that.
Think of it this way, guys. Battle for third place in the podium. You never thought Gary would be there after he spun it in reverse.
Chisholm
hasn't been there, but two Bannerball has got one more corner to go to take a big...
Chisholm's going
to
get it! Chisholm's got it!
And he's got the RS! Oh, what a manoeuvre!
Oh my god.
Gary! Oh, reverse Gary at that corner.
Two Bannerball meantime has crossed the line to take victory completely unnoticed because Chisholm's in the third. Adam finishes in second. Has no idea probably of what's going to befall him, but into third place is Chisholm. Gary is still behind, but he's got one more corner to go. Gary's lost it on the penultimate one. But
on the last one.
He's got third.
I can't believe this.
Gary will be fourth. I cannot
believe this. Final corner, and Chisholm is going to take third place.
He's happy, he's moving.
Across the line. I don't care whether that's a penalty, Joe.
It wouldn't be.
Don't you dare comment on that.
It wouldn't be. It would be if he reversed it.
Third place for Chisholm. Fantastic. 31 seconds. Or 32 seconds was the gap. So even if it was 20, it would have been enough for Tube Animal. But he takes victory. Animally second. And Chisholm in third place. Gary in fourth. Somehow recovered to get a fourth place.
And the fastest lap of the race as well with a 32.621.
Only just. Yeah. Over Tube Animal, but Blake takes fifth and Shots ends up sixth and six finishes. Wow.
That was good.
Fantastic. Reason why I'm happy because Chisholm, he's been never had the luck, but always kept on trying. Always kept on trying to get a result, and finally, I think he has had a podium before. It's not in my time.
Yeah, he's had four. I think it is fourth. I think he's had four, and now this is his fifth. That's how we worked there earlier.
Yeah, but he hasn't had one for ages. Ages, it seems.
He hasn't had one, I think it was Spain. Oh, I think it was the Spain in season 8, I think, wasn't it? He says, thinking about it. Oh no, I've hit my recorder out. Sorry about that, guys. I've literally tapped my recorder out, so they may not be able to hear you guys now. That was the slightest tap in the world. Sorry about this. They may not be able to hear Sundance and that lot. You'll just hear a load of noises in the background of did-a-do. There you go. I should hear you. Oh yeah, definitely.
Hello.
They can't anyway in stream. They can't hear you two. I think now. Now they can.
That's one, yeah. That's probably Adam's mic. Cause
I could. I don't know. Is it? Mine or is? Could be anybody's.
Oh, annoyingly, Chisholm is on busy.
I'll go into game chat and see who's there.
Yeah, tell him to come in.
Yep.
Into reverse to spin. Does Gary now get a penalty for putting it in reverse and spinning? That's a question. That's a good one, Joe. Go on, Chisholm, get a podium, says Maddie, and yes, Chisholm in capital letters, says Maddie.
It'll be a popular result, and he's on busy. Why? Why do people
come join, Chisholm? You haven't had to do this for a while, but come join.
We'll join us.
We're not gonna bite you. All right.
Right. Yay! He's in the party chat. Yay! Right, let's go through a unbelievable race. The safety car definitely spiced everything up. We had Gary putting it in reverse fantastically in the hairpin. We had battles galore, controversy as well, but at the end of it, after 57 long and tiring laps, it is Tube Animal who takes the victory here today. I believe you have had a victory before.
Yeah, but I crossed the line second, so I didn't really count it.
Didn't really count, but you've got a win outright today. Absolutely fantastic. You were up near the front pretty much the entirety of the race, but up to us, even before that safety car, do you reckon you would have stepped on stepped onto the top step of the podium here tonight?
I thought Adam was going to win it all race, so yeah, I think he would have won if he didn't have his leg spike at the end, which was pretty sad. I was enjoying the battle, but obviously I'd want to win at the same time, so it was a good race.
Definitely a good race indeed, and cements yourself a contender in this season. I'm pretty much everybody would agree. Now definitely a full-time racer, I would say, after this race, bearing in mind how many people turned up, etc. But definitely a good, enjoyable race. Sundance, do you want to ask any questions to?
Yeah, it was a great race, dude. Absolutely great.
I was asking about Tube Animal.
Oh, sorry, Tube.
I apologise, Tube.
Fantastic race, mate. Fantastic, dude. Just wondering, was you counting, as the laps were counting down, dude, was you working out who was going to get DRS on what lap? And did you breathe a sigh of relief when Adam got a leg spike in the last couple of laps? I thought you did, mate.
A lot of pressure.
But that was a great race, dude. That was a great race. You did pit under the safety car, can I ask?
Yeah.
Yes. And it did come into effect, and I did say earlier in the broadcast that the guys that would pit under the safety car would definitely get a good result in the race. But yeah, Chooks, well done, mate. Much respect, buddy. That was really good.
Indeed. So, Tube Animal on his win. Second place now for Mr. Adam Lee. Again, like Tube Animal, you were near the front pretty much the entirety of that race, but with a coming together with Gary in turn one, you drop that down to the midfield, but a massive recovery in the 15 laps after that puts you near the front. But again, safety car definitely threw the race up in the air, and we were wondering where everything was going to land. At the end of it, you had a race-long battle, well, race near the end battle with Tube Animal. Lag spike, unfortunate though, kept you in second place. Do you think the win could have been there if it weren't for the leg spike?
I can't really say, because I know Tube was quick and he was right behind. Like, it could have went anywhere, like me or Tube. But obviously, if I didn't have the leg spike, then I could have won. But I'm not condoning nothing to Tube. Tube was fast and he won the race. So, like, congratulations to Tube.
Indeed. Even despite that, though, because of XRL Button's surprising absence from this race, has to be said, everyone was expecting him to turn up, but he didn't. You now effectively have taken the championship lead. But the question is now, do you see anybody else that could challenge you near the front?
Well, obviously Button's still in the championship, because it's only one race, like, it's not over. Tube Animal, Chisholm even, Gary, I don't know about Gary, he's made a silly mistake today, I think. There's still a couple of people in the championship. Like, Chisholm showed how fast he is, like, round the Bahrain tonight, and he got rewarded with a podium.
Indeed, with this, we were just about to get onto that. Well, people are going to complain to myself and Wes as well, probably, after when they watch the stream, for any biased commentary.
Ah, there was no biased commentary from me, it was all from you.
Yeah, there was. There was a little bit. There was a
No, it wasn't.
It was.
I wanted him to finish fifth.
Okay, but it was mostly myself. But I don't care, to be honest. I do not care because for so long a podium was nearly there and you've been fighting for the entirety of that time, never giving up, never losing faith or anything else like that. And there you have it, third place after a battle with Gary on the final lap. Was very, very interesting to watch. You just nicked it from him. But you got to be a stick at it with that one.
Yeah, I mean, Gary makes mistake after mistake, doesn't he? That's his art. I mean, I was quite happy with fifth, and then I saw MM Shocks up there, and I thought, well, I've got fourth, and then obviously Gary just had a mare. Did a Gary, and then I sort of got lucky, really, again.
That's it, mate. You don't make mistakes, pick up the pieces, mate, and get the points, though.
Yeah, the safety car definitely helped me out big time, because I was sort of stranded after, like, 7 laps.
You did pit underneath the safety car, can I ask you then?
Yeah.
You're another one of the guys, so all three guys that finished on the podium all pitted underneath the safety car?
All of them did, but Draco in the race.
Yeah.
But because he pitted a lap before the safety car.
The safety car ruined my strategy because I was going to free stop. But obviously, then I went on to the options under the safety car, and Tube Gary was on the primed, so I knew that I still had to stop twice because I couldn't get the options at the end. So yeah.
Did you ever consider getting on the primes to last out in the tyre wear zone, or did it not enter your mind at all?
I already run the primes, so I didn't really want to go back onto them, and I was quicker on the options anyway, so...
Yeah. That was good advice, mate. You was unlucky there with the leg spike, mate, I must say. It looked like I see it was counting down the laps with the DRSs to see which one either you or Tube Animal would be the beneficiary getting the DRS.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, we get the leg spike, dude. He's like, oh, no. Yeah, man.
Both of our DRSs failed within the last 10 laps as well.
Yeah, Tube, you had a DRS, dude. We was watching you coming down the home straight, and you was literally right behind Adam, but you didn't use the DRS. I said to the guys, it was due, I thought you was not using it because you was thinking about your tyres, trying to make sure you didn't, like, break too much. You just said there, didn't you, that your DRS wasn't working? That was a bit crazy, mate.
I mean, I did ponder about pitting for primes again under the safety car. Then I thought, if I do like 13 laps on the options, get to the
I must say, faster. Your eyes lit up though when you see Shot's tyres was going.
Yeah,
I bet your eyes lit up though, and you was like, yes.
I mean, I had a sort of good bad race, to be honest. I hit Draco, I thought I'd cleared him, and I apparently took him out. I didn't feel it.
I didn't see that bit, mate. That was, I was watching the leaders.
It was a slight debate on whether you gave him enough room or not, but it was a very fine margin whether you did or not.
The one on Gary, though, tried to do in your jizz, and we couldn't believe that when you went round to get the second, they did the DRS on the back straight, the middle sector, and Gary came up inside and then just sort of hit it into reverse.
Bless him. Like I say, he should have been here easily, but...
Well,
it just happens sometimes. He will be. He will be eventually. Yeah. It will come, just not tonight. But at the end of tonight has been a great race indeed. A lot of great battles, a lot of great overtaking, and a great result at the end of the day. And that is sayonara for myself. Well, Sundance Kid will be taking over from now on, so...
I did it for you, Michael.
Thank you.
Best race you've
Thank you.
So far?
Yeah, we ran out in style for you, Michael.
Next race, Michael.
Next race will be China.
Which is usually a wet race.
We're not the Banter Stream. We're not the Banter Stream, but GP2. Professional. Quarantine, or whatever. Yes, the race around China will be round number 4 of this very short but sweet and quick championship in the Xcite Racing League. But for all of us here, See you until next time.
Take care, people.
Bye-bye.
Well done, Tube and Adam.
Yep, well done, guys. The race, mate. Very enjoyable to watch.